Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied about heat of reaction, and in that case we have got to know that heat of reaction depends upon the amount of heat that has been excluded or the amount of heat that has been consumed in the process. So it depends on the submission of H of product and submission of H of reactant, and on that basis only we are going to talk about what is exothermic and what is endothermic reaction. So now first of all let us talk about what is exothermic reaction. So what does it say? Let us talk about that. A reaction which proceeds with the evolution of heat is called as an exothermic reaction. So what does this mean actually? The evolution of heat will be only possible if amount of heat has been released from the system or during a reaction. So in the last lecture we have studied that the heat of reaction is basically is equals to the summation of product, enthalpy of product minus summation of enthalpy of the reactant. So if the delta H should be positive, suppose if the delta H is positive, that indicates that the amount of energy is being consumed during that process. But what happens when the amount of heat or amount of energy is being released from the process? So in that case, basically the amount of heat is being evolved from the system, and that makes the delta H to be negative. Let me showcase this thing with an example. So in exothermic reaction, what happens is the delta H is found to be negative. This is because the summation of H of product is very much smaller or is smaller than that of the summation of H of reactant. So we have the formula, that is delta H is equals to summation of H of products minus the summation of H of reactant. And in this case, suppose if the H of product is smaller than that of the H of reactants, then obviously the delta H will be negative. So this negative will clearly indicate that the amount of energy is being lost during this process or during this system when we are talking about. So therefore, for an example, if I have mentioned in this case, that is when carbon, which is present in a solid form, it will react with oxygen, which is in a gaseous state, so as to produce carbon dioxide. So in this process, the amount of heat or the heat of reaction is found to be 393.5 kilojoule, but negative. This negative sign indicates that the amount of energy has been released from this system or during this reaction. This makes the reaction to be exothermic, means exo stands for out and thermic stands for heat or energy. So that much amount of energy is been released out from the system, that makes exothermic reaction. Very much simple to understand. Now let us talk about the next one, that is what do we mean by endothermic reaction. So this is basically the endothermic reaction. So the reaction in which there is increase in enthalpy and it proceeds with a absorption of heat is called as endothermic reaction. So as it has been mentioned, that there is an increase in enthalpy. So the enthalpy will be increased only if the energy has been provided to the system, and that will make the product to have more value than that of the reactant. So what I'm talking about, let us discuss in this thing, that is in this case basically the heat of reaction will be positive. So therefore it is only possible if the summation of H of product is more than that of the summation of H of reactant. So if for that let me tell you that suppose if I have mentioned an example like N2 plus O2 to form 2 times NO, and all are being present in a gaseous state. So in this case, the delta H has been found to be plus 180 kilojoule. This indicates what? That this indicates that the energy has been consumed during the process, or the energy has been taken by the system or by the reactants or by during this process so as to complete the reaction. So this plus 180 kilojoule of energy is been consumed by the reaction, and that consumption of the energy or that consumption of the heat will make the increase in enthalpy, that will increase the enthalpy that is been for a particular process, and that's the reason the heat is been absorbed. What they have mentioned here, the heat is been absorbed in this process, and hence the name is endothermic reaction. As well as endo means the one who allows to come in, endo means in, thermic means energy in the form of heat. So a reaction in which the energy has been entering in the system or entering in the process is known as endothermic reaction. And in this process, because heat has not been evolved, heat has been consumed. So that's the reason H is said to be positive. So therefore, this H has a positive value that we have here. It was very simple to understand. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this concept very clearly and you will share this video with your friends. And just don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.